But we did have a little bit of reservations about the process.
Kanwaljit, Singh, Bakshi.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for the opportunity to speak during the second reading of Anti-Money Laundering and Counter-Financing of Terrorism Amendment Bill. Mr. Speaker, the previous speaker was just mentioning that it has taken a bit long, but I would like to acknowledge his contribution during the select committee process, and he knows that a lot of things were discussed, and it took a while before we came to the conclusion of the report, and I think that was the reason why it has taken a bit long. And I would like to also acknowledge the minister as well as the officials who have really supported the select committee process in coming out with a report, which minister has already acknowledged, and so does Stuart Nash has acknowledged the report. Mr. Speaker, this bill is the second phase of AML-CFT, which is very important, and as it has been mentioned by both minister as well as Stuart Nash, that it is because our reputation on international platform is very important. This is also part of our signatures to the international commitments that we will be working to reduce these kind of activities in New Zealand. Mr. Speaker, we have to understand how these things operate, and it is very important that we have to stop these anti-money laundering things. What happens that when some money is sourced illegally, then the people try to source from A to B and pretend that there is legal transaction, there has been sale or purchase of goods or brokerage or any kind of legal transaction, so that money looks as legal money. But in fact, that money is being, the dirty money is being turned into the legal money. So we have to be very careful, and in the world we can see everywhere in the world this is happening. The dirty money is being tried to cleaned up and brought into the system. That is why this bill, which is a balance between stopping those type of transactions, it is not only the dirty money, but the money is also being used for anti-terrorism, terrorism acts, and we want to make sure that money is not used for the terrorist purposes. The bill strikes balance between combating crime, minimizing the cost of compliance, and meeting international obligation. International obligation is one of the most important things because we are signatory to some of those commitments. Mr. Speaker, in the select committee, we received 31 submissions, which were basically, most of them were supportive of what the bill intends to do, but still there were some concerns. And in the we in the select committee recommended some changes, which mostly minister has agreed to, and we hope that this bill, when goes through the parliamentary system, it will be the one of the bills which will help to stop these anti-money laundering things. Mr. Speaker, there were some changes, like we have recommended a date where the bill will automatically come into act, and it won't go through the Council of Ministers to be enacted. And that was very important. Officials as well as some of the submitters were very keen on it. The lawyers, the accountants, the high-value dealers, and the racing board, they all submitted in this select committee process, so that we heard their concerns and we tried to address some of those during our process. Mr. Speaker, we also had some of the, this whole industry is worth billions of dollars, and we want to ensure that that money doesn't come in New Zealand. The AML-CFT Act aims to detect the debtor and debtor money laundering and financing of terrorism, so that the criminals cannot enjoy the profits of these activities or reinvest it into the further criminal activities. Mr. Speaker, with these words, I commend this bill to the House.
Peter William Seal.
Mr. Speaker, I'm happy to join.